The greedy grabby horde are a simple bunch, so driving one of their commandeered carts isn't going to be a prob for a clever clog like you. You just need to be shown the basics and you'll be away faster than a cowpat off a hot, shiny shovel. Quick tour of the controller would be good. Ooh, would you prefer to use the X button or the R2 button to accelerate?
X or R2. Let's do R2.
Okay, the basics. Press the acceleration button and your cart will move forward. Keep it down if you want to burn wool. You can achieve some pretty exhilarating speeds in this game, so let go of the button if you want to slow down for a corner or stop altogether. The brake button will stop you even quicker if you need a lubricant. Once you've stopped, keep that brake button held down if you want to reverse. Steering is done by pushing the left stick left or right, or you can use the directional buttons. Well, if you're happy with the ergonomic comfort of your controller layout, just give the old action button a Sammy.
Excellent.
You already know. Preferred controller buttons, and we can continue. And if you want to go back and alter them at any stage, feel free to do so in the pause menu or the settings menu in your pod.
Okay, so let's do the subtitles. How about that? Yeah, there we go.
100% comfortable when you're wacky racing. Am I not right, sir? In karting lingo, drifting means taking a corner in a really cool way. It's skidding, but controlled skidding, and saves all the hassle of braking. To drift, steer the way you want to go in a corner whilst pressing and holding the drift button. The cart turns to the side and skids in a visually pleasing manner, I might add.
Or X just
drift. It's advisable to hold your drift until your tires ignite. That's a good time to release the drift button and get a satisfying boost. You get my drift?
Oh, so X is the drift.
You see, that was a superb bit of drifting. Both excellent and excellent. The boost you get is from the positive thinking molecules of the Imagisphere igniting in the drift backdraft. The bigger the flame, the bigger the boost. Now, who wants to know how to steer and drift at the same time? You're doing brilliantly with the drifting. Now to drift whilst steering your
car. Already doing that.
So this time, press the drift button and steer with the left stick. Remember, DNS, drift and steer. Okay, let's try this drift and steer business again. Nailed it!
Oh, there you go.
You would. Now you're
equipped with
another string to your bow. Well, you passed your driving test with all the flying colors of the rainbow. Time to start your weapons training. No, we're not getting bogged down in the logistics of ballistics. We're simply going to show you how to blast suckers off the road. Behold the Weaponator. A serious bit of kit. Drive through it to pick it up. Then you can start collecting weapons. Each time you get one, Sackboy will be holding it, looking tougher than 9-year-old cheese and twice as dangerous.
What the hell? Pick up a weapon, fire a square.
Oh, nicely collected there, number one. You are now furnished with the Weaponator. It dishes out weapons in what we call RR distribution. RR stands for really random.
Yep.
Press the weapon button to fire. Two words, or some, like your style. Now, let's talk about how to make every shot count. Taking a hit will slow you down and make you lose slight control of your cart, so avoid it if you can. Now we're going to give you what we call a defensive weapon. defensive weapons are slightly sneaky in that they can be deployed behind you to slow down other racers or destroy incoming weapons fire. If you watch for the incoming weapon icon, you'll see it changes into a shield. This is the exact time to press the weapon button and deploy your defensive weapon. When the icon shows a shield, the defensive weapon will fire backwards to intercept the barrage from the brutes behind. Tailgaters.
These are weapon defenses, Lee. When you see a shield icon.
Now you're firing on all cylinders, you clever sack bombardier, you. Just remember, once you have a weapon, you can make use of it straight away or save it for a more dire situation. You can set the difficulty level of your game, you know. Normal is your box standard threat and hurdle setting and is nothing you can't handle. But if you're of a mind to Sunday drive with very little to do, set it to casual. You can always alter it later to
That's what I'm about to do.
Fun.
Casual. That's easier for me.
In fact, what the heck?
Yeah, I don't have to worry about platinum yet. Just gotta play on hold. Lot.
You've learned so much in such a short time. If I didn't know better, I'd think you were an android. And if you ever forget anything or you want a quick recap, get your sack tushy back here and we'll do the whole bally lot again. I would love that.
All right. I was like, no. What?